dragonfly.
One of the principles is the strongest weapon goes up front. So if I'm right-handed, then I fight with my right hand up front. So what hand do you fight with?
I am right-handed.
Right-handed?
Right,
so you would fight with the right hand in front.
Mm-hmm. That's interesting. I was kind of trying to be different.
Well, see, that works for your speed.
Right.
You got more confidence in your fastest weapons, just like the military up front. Mm-hmm. Now, your stance, your foot is about one comfortable step in front of you. Right? This hand back here protects the chin, kidneys. This hand is halfway between your head and your target. So like the attacks are fast. You get there. You want to cock up on the back foot a little bit because a lot of the attacks spring off the back foot. If I wanted to get from you and get to you, that springing off the back foot is like cocking a gun. Like that. So, this is the typical stance. You want to bring your shoulders up just a little bit. That's the typical stance. So, jab. Now, when you strike, you're closing your fist as you're reaching your target. And you don't want to overextend your arm, so you want to keep a little bit of bend in it. And you snap it back faster, almost faster than you throw it out. Because you recocking and reloading, ready to fire again. The cross, the footwork with the cross is the back foot turns on the ball and the hip. So you jab and then the cross. You turn on hip with it.
Oh, you see that? All right, hold on. You said the jab and then the
cross. Yeah. Look. Right. Watch this. Jab, cross. Hip go with it. And then the hook, jab, cross, hook. You turn the right hip with it and the knee a little bit. And you want it tight.
One more time, do it this way.
I'm gonna show you.
All right, yeah.
You want it tight, almost like a 90 degree angle. Jab, cross, hook, yeah. Now I'm going to have to do that on the face. Let's come on back some. So you jab, down this to the cross, and then the hook.
Okay.
Yep, that's really good. Really good hook. Alright. Now, outside of the hook, you got the uppercut. You jab, cross. Now with this uppercut here, you kind of squat down a little bit. And it's almost like you're using your hip to push your elbow up in that fist. Jab, cross. You always, whatever hand is not throwing an attack, it's the hand that's blocking your face inside of your body. Jab, cross. Basic hits that we do is typical on most archers in front of you. So Jeet Kune Do, you watch this back foot here, you'll spring off of it, and it's a front kick. You just knock that back foot up, you pop the front one up. Some of this comes from fencing.
Right.
Sword fighting?
Like right.
Fencing.
I see that standing.
So the front kick, slide that up, pop the front one up. And you don't want to hit with the toe. This part of your foot right here.
Wow.
Not with the toe. You're popping it up. It's also, you have and now tech, or around here. This one, almost the same footwork, except you're coming around. So this is what it would look like coming towards you. To the inside of the knee.
Guys, it's not high.
You don't want to throw any high kicks.
Yeah.
Because see, in the real world, you,
what?
Somebody, you know, grab your leg and swing you, you know, die and swing you, you know, right. Punch you in your nuts.
Right.
So you want to keep your legs low. And then in the movies, and this is something else. A lot of the Jeet Kune Do and martial arts you see in the movie, that's not what you learn in the class. The stuff that Bruce Lee does in the class is different. The movie stuff has to look good.
Right.
But in the class, it's more of a scientific street fight.
Right.
There's eye gouges and stuff like that, you know, scratches and chokes and stuff like that, that you don't usually see in the movies.
Right.
So, front kick, a round kick, then a side kick, which we actually typically do to the knee. We don't throw them to the head like in the movie.
Right.
Also, if you notice, I do this a lot. A feint. Right. You do that to distract, especially for kids. You want them to look up here and make you think you're throwing something up here. So, I'm hoping that you get their attention up here.
Right.
There's a Soltec, which is another spinning kick. This one, you don't want to do this too much because you're turning your back on your opponent, which is dangerous. But those that are really good, and this is kind of taken from Taekwondo a little bit. It's called a Soltec. It's a spinning kick. The front foot comes to make room. Like that. And then you turn around and kick. So what it would look like in a smooth move, which I don't like this one, but it's one they talk. Like that. I would never do that.
That's the only high one, you
said. Yeah, and I would never do that.
Right.
Chances are you landing that.
Right.
It's just that nobody expects you to do that.
Might have you already had them days.
Yeah.
Before you got
it. I wouldn't do that. The best kicks, if you're trying to get close, is that side kick, and now kick. There's also some pressure kicks or some teep kicks. You know, you can do a teep kick, which is kind of a Muay Thai type kick. In other kicks, you can do, you know, just put pressure down on the legs. So, that's it basically for the kicks. We do knees, you know, jab, cross, elbow. You can, if you get their head, you can put a knee into them, you know, to the body like that. You can bring the head down and do knees, things like that. But the principles of it are so simple. The moves, those are the stand-up moves. You got grappling moves, you know, with the grief, I hit for that. But it's not many kicks, not too many punches. Most of the punches are for boxing. Most of the footwork is from, you know, combination of what Muhammad Ali does and also fencing. A lot of the strikes, it's just, you know, from various martial arts. But they're so low, the moving, you know, the moving, the footwork. You know, stuff like that. A lot of that's, you know, basically he took what he loved from most arts and used what he knew he could use and put together. So in a Jeet Kune Do class, what you'll find is that a lot of the information you get in the class and a lot of techniques you see, they're being taught, but you might not use them at all. But you will be finding the ones that you want. Mm. So anybody that studies Jeet Kune Do essentially is going to be making their own art for themselves.
Mm.
Because you're learning everything in there, but you're only going to use what you feel comfortable using, what works for you.
That makes sense.
You know? If I'm not comfortable doing the groundwork, then I'm probably not going to do groundwork all the time. But you need to learn.
See, it's grappling in there too.
Yeah. It's grappling.
Learning from the master is your pay. Master is your pay. Master is your pay, punk. Learning from the master is your pay, punk.